What did you hear?
We were standing outside after the first collapse, and then I was talking to my neighbour, and then all of a sudden we heard this creaking sound and looked over, and the second wall fell and fell into the house next to it and demolished that side of the house, and then shifted the house as well. It's a timber house, so it didn't stand much of a chance.
What was it like? What did it sound like?
The initial crash was like a truck coming down the street very fast, taking trolleys. Then the wall falling was more like a creaking sound, and then just bricks falling on top of the other house. Initially, with the first collapse, there was just a lot of smoke, a lot of dust in the street, and you couldn't see a thing. And then the second one, basically the same thing happened again. There was a lot of dust, and then police asked us all to go inside because of fears of the dust storm and also asbestos. Well, the second house, which is timbers, had the entire side of it destroyed, and we've noticed it's also shifted, so it shifted to the side as well. So I'd say a lot of damage.
We're at the Collier Park, which is about 100 metres away, and we heard a big crash, and we could see a big, huge billow of smoke and part of the building collapsing. And we ran up to see if anyone was injured, because I'm a registered nurse. So we ran up to see if anyone was okay. And there was huge clouds of dust, which would have been asbestos dust and dust from bricks. But the building seemed to have collapsed completely. A two-storey, I think four or five-bedroom home that's been vacant for a number of months, if not years. But there was talk of a man being on site in a digger, and there was a fellow inside the fenced-off area. And we said, is there anyone here? You know, is the digger guy okay? And he said, oh yeah, he's fine, he's gone. I was just at the site. There's a car out the front that was totaled by the accident. And we were able to clear off the road just with our shoes so cars could pass. But the car out the front lost its back windscreen. And the other women that I was in the park with, they ran home to close their windows because they've got small children, and they were quite worried about the age of the house with the lead dust and the asbestos dust that was everywhere through the neighbouring streets, and it was a huge dust cloud. So people were trying to make sure their kids would be okay tonight.
I mean, it was just like a loud roar kind of a noise. Thought it was like a truck coming down the street. But it went on for a while, and I jumped up, checked out the back. There was no real damage or anything, and once I looked out the front door, it was all full of smoke. So I just ran outside and seen that the building had collapsed. And there was a bit of panic in the street. People were running up and down and freaking out. But I wasn't inside on the second one, but just with the first one, they wouldn't let me go back in after that. But I missed the second one completely.
Obviously, you went inside.
Not with the second one. They sort of wouldn't let us back in after the first one because they knew it was unsafe. So, yeah.
What did it sound like? What did it feel like when it first collapsed?
It was like a big rumble. It sounded a lot like a truck with the shopping trolleys on the back flying down the street. But it's just like a loud rumble, roar, shook the whole house kind of thing. Yeah.
You're lucky you went home at the time with the second collapse.
Looks pretty bad, especially in that front room. Lucky no one was in there really.
So lucky man, you weren't there for the whole thing.
Thank God. Yeah. Very scary, but thank God everyone's safe.
Yeah, the brigade was called to a building site in Pearl Street, Newtown. On arrival, the crews discovered a building under partial renovation, with a pending wall collapse. Unfortunately, when the brigade was in attendance, the two walls of the building have collapsed. And unfortunately, one of the walls have actually fallen into the adjacent building, severely damaging the front end of the house. Yeah, obviously with these old buildings, there's always a concern for hazardous materials on site. The brigade's done a recce of the area and discovered that at this stage there's no present sign of asbestos, but all crews are wearing proper protective clothing, face masks, and also have a line of hose trying to wet down any dust that may accumulate on the site. The brigade has responded their urban search and rescue crew because of the structural damage of the of the house next door to the building site. We've also enacted our heavy hazmat and hazmat units to try and render any toxins or unsafe material on the site. We also have a heavy rescue in sight for lighting and also search and rescue of the place.
And what's been done now?
At this stage, we have heavy machinery on site. There was some concern that because the storm is brewing, that loose building material may fly off site. So we have crews in position wetting down the site as a heavy machinery bulldozer renders the area safe.
Hold on.